Let us now calculate the magnetic induction due to a long cylindrical wire using Ampere's law. Here you can see if it is a long cylindrical wire with cross-sectional radius R and it is carrying a current I. Now in this situation, if we consider that this current I is uniformly distributed over its cross-section, then current density J in this wire can be written as I by pi R square. And if we wish to calculate the magnetic induction inside and outside, say at a distance small r inside from the axis at a point P, we are required to find the magnetic induction. Then by using right hand thumb rule, we can see that the direction of magnetic induction will be along the tangent of the circular magnetic line of force. And if we consider the same line, circular line, as a path M, which is in anti-clockwise manner, and we use Ampere's law on path M, then we can say the line integral of magnetic induction along this closed path M must be equals to mu naught multiplied by the enclosed current within the closed path. As the current density in the cross section of this wire is I by pi r square, the total current which is flowing and it is enclosed within this closed path M can be written as J multiplied by pi small r square, because J is the current per unit area in the cross section. So for this path, the current enclosed will be this. And in this situation, as B at every point of this path is tangential to it and it is uniform by symmetry at a distance R from the axis, we can write this B dot dl as B dl, and B can be taken out of the integration, and integration of dl for the closed path M is equals to mu naught J pi R square. And this integration of dl for the closed path, which is of radius R, can be written as its circumference. So this will be B into 2 pi R is equals to mu naught J pi R square. Here pi gets cancelled out, 1 r gets cancelled out. So the magnetic induction inside the wire at a distance r we can write as half mu naught j r. So here you can see that inside magnetic induction is directly proportional to the distance from the axis of this wire. Similarly, we find out the magnetic induction at a distance r at point Q, which is located outside the wire. Here we can consider a closed path in the surrounding of this wire, which is again a circle of radius R located at center on the axis of this wire. And say if this is considered as path N, and we apply Ampere's law for this path N, we can write, we use Ampere's law on path N, we get integration of B dot dl for this closed path N is equals to mu naught, and the total current enclosed by this outer path will be the current in the wire that can be written as I. And similar to that situation here also, magnetic field B vector and dl vector are parallel, and at every point by symmetry we can say magnetic induction is along the tangent of the circle and is uniform. It can be written as B multiplied by integration of dl for this path. We can write as 2 pi r is equals to mu naught I. This implies B at an outside point of this wire, we can write as mu naught I by 2 pi r, which we already calculated using Bio-Savart's law, that is for a current carrying wire carrying a current I located on the axis of wire at a distance r, it is given by this expression. So you must be careful about both of these expressions. For outside region, we can consider that whole current of the wire is concentrated on the axis and it is giving us the same result. And inside it is given as a proportional function, which is half mu naught jr. If we plot a graph between the distance from axis of wire and magnetic induction, here you can see inside it will be a straight line up to R equals to capital R, because B inside is proportional to R. and outside it will be a rectangular hyperbola, because here you can see B outside is inversely proportional to R. So this will be the curve which we are getting for a variation of magnetic induction with distance from the wire. So be careful about these results.